Advanced Predictions uses machine learning models to generate multivariate predictions to improve your forecasting accuracy. In this video, I'll step through the tasks required before configuring Advanced Predictions. First, enable Advanced Predictions in Application Settings. Next, review driver data. Input drivers are key factors that derive predictions accurately using machine learning algorithms. In the volume analysis dashboard, review the volume trend by period and by product, price versus volume by product, advertising and promotion spend by product and by year, and revenue distribution by product. The volume analysis dashboard gives you an overview of volume performance and how the other input drivers have performed over the last few years. Product volume forecast by drivers is displayed on the prediction dashboard. Historical and future driver data are displayed. While historical actual data for drivers can come from integrated source systems, future data can be derived through traditional forecasting methods. It can also be derived based on a setting in an advanced prediction job where it generates data using univariate predictions. You enter or modify values for the input drivers on the Input Drivers tab. The system supports cell values and smart list value types. I'll return to the prediction dashboard and show you which period I'll be generating advanced predictions. For all products, I'll be generating monthly advanced predictions for the last two quarters of the year. Now, I'll configure a calendar that includes the periods for the prediction. Advanced predictions require you to use a predefined calendar. I'll enter a name for my calendar and select a cube. For time, I'll select years and periods that cover both historical and future periods. I'll select the current year and period. I want to include the last 30 periods for historical data and 6 future periods. I'll quickly save this before setting date mappings. Date mappings define the frequency and date format in the predictions. Set the first date of the prediction period, and the system derives the rest of the dates. I plan to use GDP growth rate as a driver, so I created another calendar so I can pull beginning balance data. Configure one-time or recurring events that historically led to spikes or declines in the data. Using events helps you plan for the potential and expected occurrences. Without events, spikes or falls in data are normalized and distributed over the analysis period, potentially leading to less accurate analysis. After completing the initial tasks required for advanced predictions, you're ready to start configuring EPM for advanced predictions. Related videos are listed in the description. Perform advanced predictions in Cloud EPM Freeform and Planning Business Processes. In Planning, advanced predictions is supported in the listed application types. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.